wrapping this one up on the last couple of times. Armstrong has just been an offensive move away from turning it around here. And Perez, that may be a mistake right there, Bob. And Armstrong's going to capitalize here.
Just when it looked like Perez was going to put him away, it was Perez who made this third mistake. Now Armstrong coming on strong, capitalizing on that with a knee lift. Goes after Gary Hart in the corner.
Gary Hart up on the apron. Wait a minute, Kevin Sullivan is at ringside as well.
World Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action sanctioned by the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance.
Welcome back to World Championship Wrestling. Tony Schiavone, Jim Ross, and David Crockett ringside with the NWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling. Today on our program, a big six-man tag team event featuring the Varsity Club together. Also, we're going to see the Fantastics. Also, a man turning a lot of heads in the NWA. We're talking about Al Perez. Also here in a singles match, as well as Brad Armstrong and the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Barry Windham. And David, you have many special interviews.
That's right. I have a very special interview with a very special tag team combination. Ricky Morton, Nikita Koloff. Also, I have an interview with Lex Luger. Powerful man. He's going to be talking about Ric Flair. The World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair, is here. I'm going to be talking to him. Also, the World Tag Team Champions, Tully and Arn Anderson.
Well, I'll tell you what, Dave, we've got a lot of important people to talk about, and fans, we're also going to be talking about a lot of the big confrontations going on right now in the NWA, the situation involving the Midnight Express, and Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. And, well, not a dull moment right here, fans.
Here's somebody say, Jim Ross, is that your real face, or are you breaking that in for a bulldog, sweetie? You know something? Let me talk to you, David. You know, it seems that the confrontation has already begun, the Midnight Express against Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson, and I was scared. I was worried. I was afraid that Tully and Arn might have an unfair advantage against us because of those Four Horsemen vitamins. So you know what I did? I went in Arn Anderson's bag when he wasn't around. I snuck in there. I got a bottle of them Four Horsemen vitamins, and I wanted to check them out. So I took that top off, and I took them out, and you know what I found? I found those Four Horsemen vitamins are all shaped like Fred and Wilma Flintstone, and they're chewable. Now, right off, we can tell they don't grow too good of a head of hair because between the three of them, they ain't got one. But I thought maybe, just maybe, they might have some kind of power, some kind of physical power that they were giving the horsemen. But then I looked at Tully Blanchard's physique, and I figured Tully Blanchard, he's already made arrangements. When he dies, he's going to leave that body to science fiction. Now, let me tell you something, Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson. The fact of the matter is, it's already started, and before it's over, the Midnight Express are going to be the World Tag Team Champions, and everybody's taking sides. I heard Gary Hart out here saying bad things about us. Well, I ain't going to say nothing bad about Gary Hart because he's a very important man around TBS. He's fixed to take over Grandpa's place as the host of Super Scary Saturday because Gary Hart's so ugly, he makes Grandpa Munster look like a Playgirl centerfold. But I tell you what, after we beat Tully and Arn, after we win the World Tag Team title, he can bring Max Headroom and Alfredo Bandito over here, and we'll bump them up and send Gary Hart back to his previous occupation, haunting houses. So just remember, in a confrontation between the Midnight Express and Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson, it's just like the old saying, it's when an irresistible force meets an immovable object. And brother, I don't know whether Tully and Arn are an immovable object or not, but I guarantee you one thing, the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette are simply irresistible. Nice talking to you today, David. Wonderful time.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the United States Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express. We're going to have the World Tag Team Champions later in the program, but let's go to the ring for more action right now.
All the excitement, that's the NWA's Ricky Morton, Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton against Lee Ramsey. Tommy Young is your referee. Glad to have you with us. And a lot of excitement anytime Ricky Morton comes into the arena because you're looking at a man who's been noted for tag team wrestling, but a fine singles wrestler also, Jim Ross.
Well, Ricky Morton, of course, started his career as a singles competitor, and I know he has kept his skills very sharp in singles competition around the country. I remember him in a great series with Nature Boy Ric Flair for the World's Heavyweight Championship. So Ricky Morton is here now in the NWA campaigning, whether it be in tag team matches or single competition like we're seeing him here. He's an outstanding competitor and certainly a threat to take any singles title that's available. And a lot of them out there, Tony. He's got to have his eyes set on not only Ric Flair, but also Barry Windham, perhaps Mike Rotunda's television title as well.
Ricky, of course, will be in Macon tonight for a big event at the Coliseum. We look forward to seeing all of our fans down in Macon, another great event. And a lot of big events of the NWA around the country coming up very soon.
We'll be in our colleague Bob Cottle's hometown this Thursday night in Raleigh, this coming Friday night in Richmond, Virginia, 1 week from tonight, a great card in Philadelphia. And I'll tell you something, Philadelphia is really on fire with the NWA. Philadelphia reminiscent of Baltimore, when Baltimore just exploded with the NWA. Philadelphia's in that same stage right now.
Side headlock from Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton, who combines quickness. But one thing Ricky has that we have really made mention of many times is that Ricky has a very definite mean streak about him. He's a very popular athlete with the fans, but he's a guy that has a very short fuse.
Well, he's a kid that grew up all his life with a great deal of confidence, but not the greatest deal of size. And he learned to fight at an early age. Ricky never intimidated by anybody. There's a DDT by Ricky Morton. So he grew up running with the big boys and just taking care of himself. And I'll tell you something, right now he's going to take care of Lee Ramsey up on the top rope. High cross body press by Ricky Morton, grabbing the leg. And Ricky Morton, as we mentioned, whether it be in single competition or in tag team competition, he is an outstanding athlete.
All right, it's a win with the flying side body press. And here it is one more time, the spring, and you're right. He grew up fighting, and he's a great one. Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton. And David talked earlier about the interview. Now let's go to David at ringside with Ricky Morton.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton. Ricky, great tag team wrestler. What about this interesting tag team combination? You and Nikita Koloff.
Well, you know, first of all, I want to say something about it. Over the past couple of years, I've been concentrating on the World Tag Team belts. But now is the time and point in life. I want the World Tag, the World Single Heavyweight belt, have a Ric Flair. But when you put tag teams together, baby, there's nothing more than you create something with them. This guy right here, Nikita Koloff.
I tell you, this is not a Rock and Roll Express. This is a different kind of express right here. I talked to Punky last week. And Punky said, yeah, I'm looking for a partner, maybe to go at the World Tag Team title, maybe USA Tag Team title. I said, well, Punky, then I'd be glad to be your partner. And I think the people are going to be glad to see Punky Morton and Nikita Koloff together. So if it's a World Tag Team title, USA Tag Team title, World Heavyweight title, USA title, Barry Windham, I don't care who it is. Single Tag Team, Ricky Morton and Nikita Koloff are going to be there, and we are going to sign the contract.
What he's trying to say is, David, it's when it comes right down to the nitty grit, Nikita Koloff and Ricky Morton don't take no. Woo-hoo. All right.
That's true. Ricky Morton, Nikita Koloff, you got to watch for that tag team combination. Coming up next, six-man tag team action.
Are it. They'll jump in an alley anywhere. They are rough and as mean and rugged as they come. Sullivan wastes no time proving the point as he's going after one of the men and taking him right to the mat.
That's Don Valentine in there with Kevin Sullivan. And believe it or not, fans, all Sullivan, Rotunda, and Steiner both, all three men, have great amateur backgrounds. And we talk about that because it's so very important. We see kids come up and say, how did I get to be a pro wrestler? Well, you've got to have some type of amateur background. And look at Sullivan stomping the head of Don Valentine right here on the concrete floor in the studios of TBS.
Stands him up. Go ahead, Jim, and slaps him down.
Well, you know, Sullivan, four times won the state high school wrestling championship in Massachusetts, but he won it at four different weights, which was really tremendous. In Boston, four-time state high school champion. The last man to letter in four sports in high school in his state was Kevin Sullivan. And then we know about Steiner's great athletic ability. He was an all-state football player and an all-state wrestler in Michigan. Same for Rotunda in New York State. So we've got three great athletes in this varsity club. They are tough. And Steiner just may be the most physically imposing man in the NWA. There's a lot of our great fans from the Boys Club in Florence, South Carolina. We do appreciate them being here in the studios here in Atlanta.
Good dropkick. Speaking of South Carolina, the NWA very soon will be returning to the Exhibition Center Arena in Sumter.
Mike Rotunda now dropping a leg over Gary on Gary Phelps, the television champion Mike Rotunda, in the six-man tag team event. And I tell you, my hat's certainly off to Mike Rotunda, because during the summer of 1988, during the Great American Bash, Mike Rotunda defended that television title, Tony, against the toughest competitors in the world, and he walked out of that Great American Bash with a title still around his waist.
You know, there's a startling fact about this six-man event, and that is that Gary Hart is at ringside with the Varsity Club. Now, Kevin Sullivan, the leader of the Varsity Club, basically at many times the manager as well as a wrestler, and we wonder about any type of allegiance or alliance. You know, earlier we heard Jim Cornette have a few bad things to say about Gary Hart. It's basically, I think, you're looking at a situation where there's a lot of former friends breaking off alliances, but a lot of people in the same light teaming up.
Well, people are certainly not intimidated. Look at Steiner with Phelps upside down. Steiner is just so scary strong, man. He doesn't know how strong he is, the time bomb. He can suplex you right out of your boots from any position. Well, I'll tell you something. I think it's great because I think it's good for competition. Everybody wants to move up the ladder. Everybody wants to move up the top 10. People want to be champions. But Sullivan's got a chair. Slams the back of Gary Phelps with it. One more time, the metal chair. I think that helps stimulate great competition in the NWA. Whether it's the Varsity Club against the Road Warriors, or whether it's against the Midnight Express or Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard, that's what the NWA is all about. The greatest athletes competing nightly. And I mean, it's on the great action, just like tonight in Macon.
There's a right hand by Steiner that put him down. He lets the man go right back to the corner, and Valentine will come back in. You know, it's great for competition, but I think we're getting to the era in sports, especially in wrestling, where so much money is involved. You're going to have your definite cliques or your groups like the Horsemen, like the Varsity Club, but outside of that, you're going to have no friends anywhere, I think.
Suplex by Mike Rotunda. And between Sullivan and Rotunda, Steiner, this six-man combination, there's Sullivan, both feet right to the abdomen. And a second time, boy, he means business. And a third time for Sullivan. And this is borderline brutality right here.
He's been known to do it, but we've only seen one time. It's usually been enough.
This won't be pretty.
Belly to belly over the top. That was almost a form of a belly-to-belly suplex and a pile driver, so to speak, straight down on his head. What a move.
And look at the Varsity Club. These guys, I'll tell you something, they are definitely three of the toughest men in wrestling today. Great credentials and the motivation with Gary Hart and Kevin Sullivan. I'll tell you something, we gotta take a look at these guys. We have got to evaluate. Now that Gary Hart, that's a new ingredient to this dude.
Gary Hart was at ringside, and your winners, the Varsity Club, in this six-man event. And when we come back, fans, David Crockett talks with the total package, Lex Luger. Don't you dare go away.
Ladies and gentlemen, the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair's toughest challenge today has been from the total package, Lex Luger. The match is signed, the rematch is signed. Will Ric Flair withstand the awesome power of the total package, Lex Luger? Lex?
You know, David Crockett, I am all-time high. Physically, I'm in the best shape of my life. But more than that, it's emotional, because I am an all-time high. The adrenaline's flowing. Everything's coming my way, because I'm an all-time high for one thing, because I can reach out and I can touch it now. It's at my fingertips, and it's 20 pounds of gold and it's a World Heavyweight Championship. Nature Boy, my hat's off to you. Your level of experience, your wrestling skill, your physical skills are at their all-time peak, but they have to be, because Nature Boy, first it was the avoidance. 7 long months I had to go through Arn, I had to go through Tully, I had to go through my own tag team partner to get a shot at you in Baltimore. And then when we signed the match, you jumped me in a parking lot. Well, Nature Boy, the match came to pass. And I knew, millions of people across the country knew, but most of all, Nature Boy, you knew that you were beat. So what it comes down to, Nature Boy, is what you dreamt the whole time. Your worst nightmare is this right here. You knew, I knew, this was a test you've never had before. And Nature Boy, the rematch is coming. And the bottom line is this. You better be at your best. There's a total package left to lose after one thing. That's the World Heavyweight title. Diamonds are forever, but your world championship reign is not. The total package is coming after you.
All right, fans, will this time be the time that Ric Flair loses the World Heavyweight Championship to Lex Luger? Let's go to the ring for our exciting wrestling action.
All right, it's Brad Armstrong, Dave Spearman in the Savannah World Championship Wrestling, and I think Lex Luger made a good point. And the point is that Flair is at his peak right now, Luger is at his peak right now, so the rematch sign when both men are at their best, and sometimes you don't get that in this sport, and it's good to see that happen.
Shouldn't be any excuses. Undisputably, number one against number two, Flair versus Luger. And a lot of fans, a lot of mixed opinions about what's going to happen in this final go-round for these two athletes. But right here's an athlete that I'm so impressed with, Brad Armstrong, from nearby Atlanta and Marietta, Georgia. Second generation wrestler. He comes from a real wrestling family, an American proud family. And Brad Armstrong is a young man that we mentioned before, that I think early in his career maybe got a little bad advice from some legal people as far as negotiating championship matches and big matches. And I know that right now, though, he's back on track, and that young man right there has got one of the most outstanding futures in this sport, because he has got great strength, great upper body strength, but his quickness and his counter-wrestling ability and is just beyond compare for a man that is like him in years.
I think the fact like him in years, Jim, because he was so young, he was a champion before he was 20 years old. And so I think it's the process of Brad Armstrong, not only with good advice now, but a maturity process for him right now. He's older, he is wiser, he knows how to take care of his sport, his profession now. And he, as a result, getting big matches, getting more recognition around the country this time.
Armstrong with the armbar on Dave Spearman. And still to come, ladies and gentlemen, we'll hear from Paul Jones. We understand there's a little problem in the camp of Paul Jones. David Crockett will address that situation with Mr. Jones. We're also going to see perhaps the hottest man in the NWA right now as far as one win-loss record and also the time it takes him to beat people. Al Perez doesn't waste a lot of time, and that's who we're talking about. Al Perez, the Latin sensation, is red hot here in the NWA. And I think we got to say Brad Armstrong right now, looking at the string of victories that we have seen Brad put together, Tony, in the last few weeks, he's got to be ranked right there with Al Perez as guys that are peaking, they're hot right now. They have a hot streak going. Like the Red Sox just had a few weeks ago in baseball. Just like they couldn't lose.
Until they met Detroit. Armbar right on to the left arm now with a good step over. Brad Armstrong right on Dave Spearman. You're right about Armstrong being hot right now. It takes a lot of confidence to be able to perform in the ring on nationwide TV or in many arenas around the country. You gotta have it. Perez has it. Armstrong has it. And right now, Brad Armstrong, with all the quickness, he's ready for that Russian leg sweep. Here it is.
Floats right over on top. Armstrong grabs the leg. He's as sound as a dollar. Fundamentally sound. He is a wrestling machine. Brad Armstrong is really getting hot right now here in the NWA, and the month of August not only has been hot around the country, but Brad Armstrong, like Al Perez, has warmed it up even more here in the NWA.
All right, David Crockett talks with Paul Jones, and also we will see Al Perez in action, plus much more to come. Don't you dare go away.
Had a very rough summer, I should say. Paul Jones, things really haven't been going well for you, Paul.
Well, you know, David, if you told me that you were going to shoot every cow in Texas, I would believe you. And if you didn't get the job done, I would never believe you again. And if you told me you hung the moon, I would say do it again because I want to see it for myself. Now, what I'm trying to say is I told you people at the beginning of the summer that Powers of Pain, number one, Paul Jones, was going to eliminate the Road Warriors and Elric. Well, they're still running around. So there's a problem in my camp. I laid my organization out, and the first one I looked at was the Big Russian. And I said, this man is everything Ivan Koloff said he was, and more. So then I looked at Ivan Koloff. And I said, here's a man that's been my friend. Here's a man that I know that I will never have to tell him what to do other than mold him to the marvelous mind that I have and the way I want things done. And Ivan Koloff let me down. And I approached Koloff and I told him, you better shape up or ship out. He had big horse tears coming out of his eyes. And he said, I feel deep down inside I may have been lacking a little bit. I don't meet the expectations that you want me to meet, but I will. And Ivan Koloff said, Paul, from now on, you're going to see a new man, a man that puts out 110%. And that's all I need to eliminate the Road Warriors. You see, because I want victims, not victories. Now, you're looking at a man 6'8", 330 pounds. He could beat any three men by himself. But I have an organization. And there's one man that takes the glory, and that is Power of Pain, number one, Paul Jones. I want it done. Road Warriors, consider yourself gone.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard from Paul Jones. It does seem like he's having problems in his camp. Listen, let's go to the ring for Gary Hart and Al Perez.
Now we're going to take a look at the man we've been talking about, Al Perez, with Gary Hart against Max MacGyver. And before we get started here, just to touch on something that Paul Jones said, on the surface, it appears that Ivan Koloff has done a great deal for Paul Jones. We always talk about his influence on the men, his influence on the Russian assassin, and his ability in the ring, such as a third man or a coach in the ring.
Jones may want to reevaluate what he's been saying and go back and look at the game plans that he's been assembling. He may want to look in the mirror. Some of the blame may need to be not just put on one individual, because I think Ivan Koloff has had a successful summer in as much as that, you know, he has battled the Road Warriors, I mean, up and down the scaffold, and has survived. So, to me, that's a pretty good accomplishment right there.
Well, you know, sometimes when things go wrong with the team, you have to look at the leadership sometimes.
Well, that's exactly right. Hey, the manager's the first one to go. Ask Chuck Tanner.
That's right. Right hand, right onto the face.
Al Perez is in great condition, as we can easily see. I'll tell you something. He's going to get better and better all the time. And again, Gary Hart's influence. We made the comment when Al Perez first came to the NWA that Gary Hart did not associate himself with losers. What a unique move by Perez. I tell you something, going right now for the spinning toe hold, Al Perez is a wrestling machine. A little bigger version of Brad Armstrong, but we mentioned both these men right now are red hot here in the NWA. And Perez one more time with a victory. I want to tell you something. That's one move. We know that Dusty Rhodes has got bad wheels. And if Perez gets a chance to get Rhodes in the spinning toe hold, you can bet that he will have the green light from Gary Hart to tear it completely out.
There's no doubt, knowing what Hart feels about Dusty Rhodes and knowing the type of athlete we have in Al Sal Perez. Another great move and another great win for a phenomenal athlete. Oh, look at that. His name is Al Perez. And right now, David Crockett at ringside with Gary Hart and Al Perez.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Gary Hart, Al Perez, one of the greatest young wrestlers in the world today.
Absolutely, without a question of a doubt. One of the young lions of professional wrestling that is practically unbeatable. Now, you talk about Dusty Rhodes. You say there's a man 280 pounds, a seasoned veteran, as tough and bad as they come. Well, jump on him, Rhodes. Jump on him. And your partner, Dickie Murdoch, the original Outlaws. I don't care. I believe any partner I pick, if it's Kevin Sullivan, if it's Ronnie Garvin, if it's one of the varsity club, put them with Al Perez. They are so diversified that there is no way in the world that Rhodes and Murdoch can beat them in a team or in a single. And one other thing I'd like to bring out. Every week, week after week, I listen to these wrestlers talking about, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. I ain't seen you do nothing. All I've seen you do is come out here and talk about it. And one thing that I really want to do, you know, I want to make a personal apology to Dickie Murdoch. You know, I said that Dickie Murdoch danced with Dusty Rhodes' big, fat, ugly sister, which he did. Now, imagine Dusty Rhodes' sister. Imagine Dusty Rhodes in a print dress, brown and white Oxfords, and a butch cut, you know? I think she might be a little, too, you know? But one thing that I must say, when Dusty wasn't at the dance, Dickie Murdoch used to carry a feed bag in his pocket, and he put it over the woman's head. The only one uglier than Dusty Rhodes and Dickie Murdoch that I have ever noticed in my life. The ugliest woman in all of Texas, and there's a lot of ugly women in Texas, and you Texans sitting there right now, turn around and look at your wife or your daughter, and then tell me I'm lying. But your wife and your daughter or your grandmother or your aunt or anybody ain't quite as ugly as Dusty Rhodes' sister. Now, I don't know what more I can say, Rhodes, unless I tell about your mama dipping snuff, wearing white socks, and fly sack something that them Texas women wear. I see you later. Butchie, you know who I'm talking about too, don't you?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard from Gary Hart and Al Perez. More action to come after these messages.
The U.S. champion, Barry Windham, going up against Curtis Thompson in this event as we take a look at certainly one of the most dominant forces in our sport, the U.S. heavyweight champion, Barry Windham. We have some big events coming up in the NWA, and you know, Jim, as we take a look at James J. Dillon, the leader of the Four Horsemen, there's no doubt the Horsemen have their work cut out of them on all sides.
Well, they certainly do, and I know that Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard are certainly involved in the situation involving the Midnight Express and the Tag Team Championship of the World. That's certainly one of the hottest situations in the sport today.
All right, we have them standing by. We're talking about Tully and Arn. Let's go to them right now.
You know, I tell you what, Arn, you sit here, you watch BW, one of the Four Horsemen, United States Heavyweight Champion, looking great like only the Horsemen can, but then you got to think about Cornette and the Midnight Express.
Tully, I used to think Bobby Eaton was something near and dear to my heart, but Bobby, when you let a man do your thinking for you, and we've not established that he's even got any male hormones, then I got to figure that ugly broad that I used to haul all over Charlotte, I got a bad rap in Charlotte, North Carolina, because everybody thought I was hauling some broad around with scraggly hair, needed a touch of rouge, and a little eye paint. The bottom line is, Bobby, what we used to have or used to be is this right broads we toss aside in Stan Lane. You like to snake it. Not Johnny Jackson, and the bottom line is, Lane, you've got too many tendencies to chase women and keep your mind on all things other than having a good fight. If you want to be world champion, you put your broads in the proper perspective and you take care of business first. We're the Horsemen, first and foremost. Midnight Express are runners-up, second best, always will be, always have be. You want to be a world champion, change your lifestyle, do your own talking, because you got to do your own fighting, just like the Horsemen always have. That's why we're world champions.
You know, Cornette, the one thing you get on TV and talk about how everybody is always, you've taken them down and put them down. You may have, but see, the one thing that all your other opponents, they're always worried about you too much. You can buy a ticket, come if you want, don't come, it makes no difference. We're after you, Lane and Eaton.
There they are, the World Tag Team Champions, and here's the U.S. Champion. You know, from all sides, the top challengers are here for Flair and Lex Luger, for Tully and Arn, of course, with the Midnight Express.
I'll tell you something, the Stinger, I know, is really adamant about getting a U.S. title opportunity against Barry Windham, and what a matchup those two young stallions will have, but also the veteran, the old war horse, Dusty Rhodes, now from Allen, Texas. He wants a shot at the U.S. title that he really never lost. He never lost in the ring, lost in the boardroom. But right here, can Dusty Rhodes or can Sting combat that big gloved right hand, the claw hold, and the power of Barry Windham? That is the question. Can Dusty Rhodes or the Stinger beat this man? And that is going to be one tall order, 6 feet, 6 inches tall, we should add.
All right, David Crockett getting set to talk with James J. Dillon and the members of the Four Horsemen.
Right here we see the Claw, Barry Windham, all 6'6", Curtis Thompson, no slouch. He's a tremendously well-conditioned athlete, very, very strong. But Windham and the Claw, too much. And now he's standing by with David Crockett.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the United States heavyweight title, the champion, Barry Windham, the Claw, Barry Windham. There's a man, the Sting, with the scorpions after him.
Well, I thought it was awful quiet in here, Barry. I didn't hear any hooting and hollering and yelping today. Apparently, Sting's not here. Maybe a few victories like that with the Claw put a little fear into Sting.
You know, as I've said before, Sting seems to think, and you seem to think at times, that I can't do it without the Claw. Now, you know well that I am, and that I was before the Claw came off, the best tactician in professional wrestling. I know every hold, I know every counter. Sting, Dusty Rhodes, all this is my ace in a hole, so to say. When I put this Claw on Dusty's head or on Sting's head, doesn't matter who they are, how big they are, how high they can jump, or how hard they can pound in a chest, they all lay down on the mat and they all say, please, Barry, let go of my head. Let go of my face. It hurts too bad. Sting, when I get a hold of you, I will put your shoulders on the mat, and the U.S. Championship will stay home with me as always.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll see about that when Barry Windham and Sting collide. Listen, more action to come. Hang on to your seats. Champion ever, Ric Flair, the king in his court, the horseman, look at him.
What we have right here is a family situation that causes distress to the hearts of every wrestler in the world today. And Lex Luger, the bottom line is, you came out here and you called it as you saw it, and that is Ric Flair and the Horsemen are at the peak of their game. In other words, the World Tag Team Champions, the United States Heavyweight Champion, the mastermind that controls it all. And in my own humble little way, I'm just the World's Heavyweight Champion. So Nikita, Luger, Sting, Dr. Death, oh, the Road Warriors, Lex Luger, and last but not least, Your Highness, Sir Dusty Rhodes. Y'all just have to go out back and pull your own chain, because there's nobody here in this great family that really cares what you think, what you want, or what you can do, because as Arn Anderson said, all you know is what we tell you. That's the bottom line, because we are the Horsemen. We are the world champions. We are the very best. Woo! that this sport has to offer. And a lot of you wrestlers out there, a lot of you fans out there don't like it. But the bottom line is, once again, learn to like it, because it is, woo, the best thing going today. God bless each and every one of you. You got a problem? You got a problem? It's no problem. Look us up. Woo!
It's been your pleasure as usual.
ladies and gentlemen, the Horsemen, you've got to say that they definitely rule the wrestling world. Let's go to the ring for a lot of great action.
All right. Here we go.
The Boys Club from Florence, South Carolina, they're mobbing the Fantastics as they circle the ring here.
Yeah, they're going to mug them before they get into the ring, but there is no doubt that is out of popularity. These two men. You know, right now, as we take a look at the Fantastics coming in, the issue is Tully and Arn against the Midnight Express, but by no means, and I don't think they're going to do this because they are professionals, by no means will Tully and Arn nor the Midnight Express rule out the threat that the Fantastics pose to both those titles.
And the Road Warriors and the Sheep Herders and the Varsity Club. I mean, you can go on and on. There's a lot of great tag teams right here, and that could be wrestling each other as they start eliminating each other and jockeying for position in the top 10 to move up the ladder. Well, this is the Holiday brothers, Brad and Brett Holiday. Not to be confused with Brett or Bart Maverick of the Maverick
That's fame. Right. I was confused for just a second, but I appreciate you clearing that up for me.
Also, we want to remind the fans that next week we'll be back here for a two-hour broadcast here on the Superstation. Nice dropkick by Bobby Fulton.
You know, another thing is we talk about not overlooking the competition. Ric Flair's a man that doesn't. Of course, Lex Luger is on Ric Flair's tail, the number one contender, but there are guys like Sting, Nikita Koloff, who want a shot, Ricky Morton, who want a shot at that title, Brad Armstrong. And we've even heard, we've talked about Al Perez, and Al Perez wanting to be a champion. Well, there's plenty of titles out there for him to get.
Fantastics with a victory right here in the Superstation.